Beyond the edge of knowing, there is another world. A world made of myth and dream and mystery. There is another layer of reality embedded in the hills and moving beneath the waters and ensconced amongst the roots of the trees and shining amongst the stars and the darkness in between. There is another layer of reality behind the mind and beyond comprehension. At this time in the year, the veil between the worlds is thinnest. The other world is close. A world which exists beyond all the stories of separation. A world of pure, dreaming consciousness. A world of animacy. We all are intermediaries at the threshold in between life and death. Fall and winter, the waking and the dreaming. When the shadows gather, when the night begins, prepare to meet whatever is revealed in the luminous darkness. Seems strange or unruly or inhuman. The dark messengers which arise in the dreaming mind come from beyond the human world. They are emissaries of another way of knowing. The other world contains multitudes, ancestors, allies, and adversaries. They are emissaries of the life we don't know that we are living. This is the time to befriend shadows. This is the time to practice clear seeing, clear knowing, clear being, clear becoming. In a world of infinite consciousness, it is a responsibility to choose how to abide within it wisely. The autumn is a hypnagogic experience, like the time between waking and dreaming. It is filled with kaleidoscopic colors, patterns of movement, and wild abundance. This is the time when consciousness shifts and the other world offers its qualities generously. Whatever has been hidden beneath the surface is revealed. There is a blossoming up from within, a flush of instantiations of the shadows, like a murmuration of birds moving into consciousness. Enter the dreaming mind of autumn. Here, every perception is a mask for a deeper and wilder energy which abides beneath its surface. Here, there are many faces, many beings, many kinds of knowing, each of which have been hiding under the mirage of a seemingly ordinary experience. Threshold of the other world. Be simple. Walk without pretense, without hiding. Don't subscribe to any particular identities. Release them all. Let them follow their own patterns and their own destinies. You are not any of the things that you seem. You are the flow. You are the current. You are the dark waters emerging from the wellspring. Don't hold on to anything too tightly. Lay down the ambitions of the ordinary world and the masks that you wear to protect from being seen. You don't need those in the other world. Let them incubate. Let them receive medicine of rest and sleep. Allow the losses that you have experienced to wash through you. The dark waters that cleanse the heart and clear cellular memories. This is a time to release something that you are holding on to, or something that is holding on to you. Whatever it is, a love, a loss, an expectation, a hungry ghost but is always restless, an ambition, a grievance, an old patterning. This is the season to say goodbye to many things. This is the season to say goodbye generously. Choose what you can let go of. Give it to the other world. Let the full moon illuminate the moment of your release. Let the luminous darkness shine upon the waters which carry what was yours onto a new resting place. Let the flowers die. Let the frost come. Let the forest fade. In the slow surrendering of the light, let the night have its day. Don't be afraid to give up the bright manifestations of life. Let go of the colors and the radiance and the sun. Give up the leaves one by one. There is just as much beauty in the liminal spaces beneath the surface. There is just as much radiance in the dark places of the living earth where life originates. There is nothing out of place. There is nothing to deny or to delay. Everything is happening according to the timeless patterns of sacred geometry This is a kairotic moment, a natural turning point. This moment is ordained by the sun and the moon and the stars. This is the perfect time to bring attention inward, into the incubation of the inner life. Let attention settle down into the rhizomatic networks in the living earth. Let the mind sink down into the deep taproots. As the autumn sets in, let the pace of life slow. And slow still more. Don't worry about what you are missing out on. Return to the other world, where the mysteries arise naturally from the quiet spaces and timeless meditations already available in your being. You are made of time and place and season. Let the mind melt into the present moment. Activate the cellular intelligence of autumn. The portal to the other world is here already in the mind and the body. At the threshold of the other world is an opening to new wisdom streams. At the threshold of the other world is a portal of many possibilities. Enter the imaginal mind of autumn. Receive the gifts that are waiting for you. When the veil between the worlds is thinnest, we can shift our perceptions of reality. When the veil between the worlds is thinnest, we can awaken a new story. From within the earth and the waters and the potential of human beings, from the influence of the stars and the aliveness that arises from within all things, there is a possibility of the evolution of the human family. This is the time to go within and invite a deeper dream. Dream a dream of the earth. Dream a dream of aliveness that is greater than life and death. dream the dreams of the ancestors and the future generations who are dreaming through us. The other world is infinitely generous with its capacity to reinfuse this world with new consciousness.